In previous videos, I've described how acetyl-CoA is produced from the breakdown of triacylglycerols and the beta-oxidation of fatty acids. In most tissues, the acetyl-CoA produced is used in the citric acid cycle to provide electron carriers for ATP production. However, the brain cannot take up fatty acids and does not carry out beta-oxidation to produce acetyl-CoA. Therefore, the liver diverts some of its acetyl-CoA to production of ketone bodies. The three compounds that are collectively called ketone bodies are acetone, acetoacetate, and beta-hydroxybutyrate. Two of them contain ketone groups, and the third is just an oxidized version of one of the others. These three compounds can cross the blood-brain barrier, and the brain will convert them back into acetyl-CoA for use in the citric acid cycle. Therefore, production of ketone bodies by the liver allows the brain to obtain energy from stored fatty acids. The liver makes ketone bodies under low glucose conditions as a way of providing an alternate energy source to the brain. The main concept is illustrated on this diagram. The liver, but not the brain, is able to absorb fatty acids from the bloodstream. The liver uses some of the fatty acids for its own energy needs, but also converts some acetyl-CoA to ketone bodies, which it releases into the bloodstream. The brain picks up these ketone bodies, converts them back into acetyl-CoA, and uses the acetyl-CoA in the citric acid cycle and oxidative phosphorylation to produce ATP. Now, ketone bodies are not used only by the brain. Other tissues, such as muscle cells, can take up and use ketone bodies for energy. But the main purpose of ketone bodies is to provide energy to the brain. During an extended fast, the brain will get most of its ATP by metabolizing ketone bodies. In a future video, I'll explain how the liver's various responses to an extended period of low blood glucose relate to each other. But before we get to that, I want to describe fatty acid synthesis in the next video.